What's up, everybody, and welcome to the Brilliant Idiots Podcast. And today it is brought to you by Squarespace, okay? From websites and online stores to marketing tools and analytics, Squarespace is the all-in-one platform to build a beautiful online presence and run your business, okay? There are no hidden fees or price hikes, and all websites are optimized for mobile. And it's so simple. You can just start with a design template and use drag and drop tools to make it your own. How do you do it? You head to squarespace.com/idiot for a free trial. And when you're ready to launch, use the offer code IDIOT to save 10% off your first purchase. Now let's start the show.
It's so stupid, it's positively brilliant. What's
up, everybody? It's your boy Schulze. Charlamagne is not here today. He has a special secret that he's handling, okay? And maybe you guys will know about that secret in the future. Maybe you will not. But I've been told that this secret is not out there in the world. Right, Taylor? Taylor, what, Al?
I don't know.
Wax?
I don't know what's going on.
Oh, I hate starting the pod on a lie.
But what are you talking about? It's not a lie for me not to know what's going on.
You do know what's going on.
I don't know nothing.
You know everything.
Me?
Yeah.
All right. Well.
Well, we have Akash Singh filling in for Charlamagne today, and Akash also knows the thing that we're lying about. But it's somebody else's personal business.
I know. I'm not going to say what it is, but I know. I won't lie. We all know. Cop, please, like wax.
Taylor is on the mic today. Now that Charlamagne's not here, I refuse. I refuse to silence black women. I don't silence black women. Not on my podcast, not on any platform of mine will I silence black women. We'll see how long that lasts today. I might pull the plug right out of that fucking mic, but I am not silencing black women on this podcast today. Taylor, welcome.
Hi.
How are you?
I'm good. How are you?
Here's your big shot. Be interesting.
I'm always interesting.
Here we go. Here we go.
I agree.
They just typed in www.reddit.com on their browsers, and they're getting ready to roast. Listen, we are here today. I'm sure Charlamagne will explain why in the near future. You guys will know, but yes. All cool, good things. So don't be concerned. Like, this is that all great. Mm-hmm. Blessings, blessings, blessings. God is good. Okay. What is the saying? God is good.
All the time.
All the time.
All the time. All the time.
All right. All right? Yeah. Good shit. Okay. So we got some things going down here. Taylor, you put together some notes for us. Snoop Dogg announces next album on Tonight Show. Plus Def Jam Kids album 2.
It's positively brilliant.
Oh, that's positively brilliant?
Yes, he has to scroll up.
Why is that positively brilliant?
What do you mean?
That Snoop Dogg announces new album on the Tonight Show plus a Def Jam Kids album 2.
You don't think, no? You don't think that's cool?
I don't understand. No, nobody watches the Tonight Show.
I mean, I only listen to gospel.
I'm just bigging up black excellence, so whatever.
What is Def Jam Kids?
That's something new, I guess, for songs for kids.
Congratulations, that's dope.
How do you feel about it, Wax?
Wait.
I promise you only listen to gospel. I ain't gonna lie.
The only music you listen to is gospel.
It's only gospel. Look, you see what I got on my fucking leg? This is what I walk around every day with. Like, I have to have gospel music in my ears to walk around
with. This is absolutely terrifying. Can you throw me this mask right here? I can't believe that you walk around with this mask.
I have to walk around.
You're asking for it. You're asking for people to be afraid.
I'm asking, the fuck am I asking
for?
No,
I would be way more scared.
What do you mean, what are you asking
for? No.
Huge black guy with fucking dreadlocks. You're walking around with a skull mask like the Predator.
There's
reason to be scary.
No, that mask is only scary for white guys wearing it. That's a serial killer mask.
Yes.
Black people aren't serial killers. Wax, no mask, way scarier than wax with that mask.
Can I say something? And this is something that you should all know. White guys do not use masks to serial kill.
No,
we use get away with our whiteness. Yeah. You would never expect that we were going to be killers, and then we take you, we snatch you up, and then we kill you.
That's a good point.
You walking around with this, you're being an asshole.
No, I'm not.
You're being an asshole.
I'm not being
an
asshole.
What is this for? What are you doing with this?
This is for my airsoft paintball spot.
But you're not
my mask.
But are you playing paintball today?
Yes, I was actually, but I just bought it to let everybody know they are for sale. You want to go ahead and go to Who's Wax Paintball?
Oh, this is an item that he's selling. You're like Soldier Boy on this podcast, dude. Come on. Every single week, he got a new item that he's drop shipping.
This is wax. I don't know nothing.
Apparently. Can you just put this on?
He's like raging.
You like this?
He really is. He got AirPods,
WaxCon headphones.
I got everything, brother.
Listen. Okay, this is good. There you go.
Great.
Yeah.
Oh no, that's scary as fuck.
Yeah,
it's scary.
It's terrifying.
It's scary.
It's terrifying.
You look like the Predator.
Honestly, Wax, you look better.
Yo, Taylor with a bar, Reddit. Don't hate on that. That was funny. That was an actual funny line that Taylor just said right there. Come with heat.
Man,
okay, Wax, I'm going to call the cops if you don't take that off right now, dude.
Yeah.
I'm not playing around.
If you want to look as scary as me on Halloween or something, you know.
Okay, make sure you go get them. Where can they get the masks?
Who's Wax? Right net.
Okay,
who's
we got it. Keep scrolling down, Taylor. I need
dot net, dog.
Keep going.
You can't even get a dot com, bro.
I'll tell you.
These are all positive. Positively brilliant. Keep going.
Okay, this is positively brilliant. Let's start with what a fucking idiot. Let's start with what a fucking idiot. Okay, haunted house worker accidentally stabs 11-year-old when attempting to scare him.
Wait.
Stab him with what, though?
But yeah, like...
A real knife.
But why would you have a real knife?
Yeah.
Isn't this supposed to be a joke?
I don't know. Click on the link.
You're supposed to read these fucking articles.
Oh, you want me to read them? Okay.
Yeah, before.
Beforehand, I think is the idea.
Okay, yeah, this is absolutely crazy. But that haunted house is legit. I don't know. Al, what are we thinking?
So basically, the man was allegedly wielding a knife he would have brought from home and began scraping the ground as the child approached with a friend. And basically, the kid wasn't acting scared. So to scare him, he stabbed.
Hold on. He stabbed the kid's toe. And the kid was wearing Crocs. Fuck that kid.
Yeah, that's on the kid.
Fuck that kid, yo.
Why?
Get a real sneaker where your toes is protected.
Yeah.
You're wearing a Croc. Yeah. Obviously, you're going to get stabbed in your foot.
Anything can happen with the Crocs on it. Open. Like, anything can happen with your shoes that you have on.
Yeah. You can't go in flip-flops.
Exactly.
Why not?
Why were you dressed that way?
Yeah, he was asking for
it. He really was asking for it.
Yeah.
You came to the fucking haunted house in Crocs?
That's only like 40% of your feet covered. Like, you don't give a fuck.
Can we be honest? You work in a haunted house. You like scaring people. And then this cocky little kid walks in wearing Crocs. Like, there's no way I'm going to be scared. I'm not going to have to run out.
Yeah.
I'm not going to be terrified at all. You're going to want to scare that motherfucker. I bet the next time he come in with some Timberlands.
Hell yeah.
Some steel toes.
Or some Jordans or something.
Yeah.
Be ready for action.
Come on
now.
It's a haunted house.
Why are you trying to protect this kid?
I didn't run.
Because he's a child.
We don't know
like,
that.
What do you
Who
mean?
Dressed him?
We don't know that. How do we know he's a child?
Right now, he's 11 years old.
You can look
his parents let him
right
walk
now.
Outside with Crocs like that to a haunted house. Parents are accountable as well.
Come on, yo. How old was Mulan when she started getting busy?
That's a good point.
She was probably 11 years old.
Saving
Mulan,
the country.
Right? Like, so, come on, yo. People have done great things at 11 years old. Definitely put on some real fucking sneakers.
You know what I was doing
Crocs.
At 11?
So y'all don't have Crocs
What were you
at
doing
all?
At 11?
Running. Yo, I went to therapy yesterday, right?
And?
It's like a new version of therapy. It's like, now I get to listen to like to my talk. That curse of therapy is out. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, yeah.
Fuck yeah. Taking mad time. Yeah. Talking all slow and shit. You know what I'm saying? So I told the motherfucker. Yeah, because everything is a fucking hour.
$100
an hour. Oh, it's going to be 3 hours before you fucking end up talking. So she was like.
Oh, yeah, if you're billing by the hour, they might as well talk slow.
Yo, so your name again. You don't know my fucking name?
Yeah.
So now we're doing a shit that people get to and talk, like audiobook shit. So now I get to talk to you after. I talk to Carla after. So that's my therapy. So now I get to yell at the lady no more. I get to yell at Carla.
What do you mean?
What the fuck did you just say, Max?
Are you all in the same room?
No, yeah, the lady is like the audio book. So it's not like somebody...
I don't understand what's happening.
You talking about Zoom?
It's no. It's an audio person talking to me.
Over the phone.
Over the phone!
No. It's a recording.
It's recording?
I'm listening to a recording.
Of what?
I feel like a therapist.
How is she
going to hear what's wrong with you if it's a fucking recording?
That's what I'm saying. Every time they tell me what's wrong, I yell at them. So nobody could talk to me like that. So now they're telling me what's going on in life. It's called respect versus love. So that's my new therapist right now.
You're so fucked up, you need a pre-therapist.
Yeah, so now...
Your therapist got to screen you.
So now now she sit there and stop it. What do you learn about that? And I was like... Okay, I could get better with this. I understand. So that's a little bit better than somebody telling me.
But that's not therapy.
Yeah.
Because they're not working on your problems.
Yeah. He's getting over on you.
This is the best thing for therapy. Person. This is cheaper, way cheaper.
Yeah. I mean, hot dogs are cheaper than therapy, but it doesn't make them therapy, right? Like,
hot dogs.
Right?
I like his therapy better.
Say again?
It takes an hour out of my day to talk about my feelings and shit.
Yeah. But are you actually talking about it with you and Carla, or are you just
me and Carla talking about it after the lady tell us what's going on? But it can't be like a real person.
How much are you saving doing this?
$100 an hour. I'm saving.
She just got YouTube videos.
I don't know
where she get it from, but she repushed the plate, and I got to sit there and listen.
Have you ever heard
and
anybody
smoke and drink tea?
And drink tea. Now, have you ever heard anybody say, like,
I think you could drink tea was on with the any rocks, therapist.
And then we started this audiobook, and then it completely saved us.
Literally with that love and verse and respect just now said.
Really?
Like, I promise, that's literally what the guy was saying. It was like, yo, we was going to go to, this was their last step. They was going to that Friday to go to get divorced. And they—
Are you talking about the book, Love and Respect?
Is that what this shit is?
Oh, there's a book called Love and Respect. It's a Christian-based relationship book. Shout out to my homie, LJ. He's the one that told me about this book, him and his wife.
LJ, you in the same boat.
Luther Jackson shouts, but is that what you're talking about?
I guess.
You listen to an audiobook about relationships? How does that help you, Wex?
What the fuck you mean? Because I don't get fucking respected. What the fuck you talking about? And they don't speak my language.
Son, imagine showing up to therapy with that mask on.
That's what I was going to do.
You're not getting no advice, bro.
What?
You're not getting no advice.
That person right there need help too.
Yes.
But that's the person who really needs help, though. Yeah. That's what y'all understand.
The problem is you don't think you need help.
I don't.
Exactly. So then why are you going to fix therapy?
Because I have to.
Because you have to, exactly.
Who said?
So you don't even think that you need help, right? So then you're in there thinking that there's nothing that needs to be changed. So when this woman is telling you to change shit, you're like, change what? I'm perfect.
Now you understand what I'm going through.
But it must be difficult. It's like, if you really think about it, right? If you're let's say you're the fucking, you're Michael Jordan.
Yep.
And you got a coach.
Iverson.
Well, it doesn't matter.
Yeah. Practice.
You got a coach, exactly. Iverson, you got to be a practice. And you're like, motherfucker, I dropped 30 a game. Tell these bums practice. They not dropping 30. Exactly. I'm out here dropping 30.
No, I'm with you.
Right? Now here's the question. Why do you think that you're so good at being in a relationship? Why do you think you're the Iverson of being in a relationship? What makes you so good at being in a relationship?
Because I think it's only so much you can do when it comes down to protecting and providing. Protecting and providing she has is like, what else a man supposed to fucking do?
You do protect the fuck out of.
You protect her.
Protect, provide for her. So provide. What the fuck else a man supposed to do? Did y'all learn anything else a man supposed to do?
Well, yeah,
it's
maybe
supposed to be emotional and everything else.
Yeah, you hang out. You can enjoy your time together. Do you guys have conversations?
About protecting and providing.
Is there any... You ever watch a movie together and be like, that was pretty cool?
Protect and provide.
That's it. There's the only thing.
If it's a movie you're watching, it's going to be like the army movie and stuff. I'm like, okay, I got to get those. I got to get those flashlights.
Yeah.
I got to do this. It's like, everything is based on a build me and build her. Things that she should hopefully have me watch is things to build her.
And what's her job?
To make sure I can help.
Be protected and be provided for.
No, help me help us to protect and provide.
You know what I'm saying? Yeah.
That's her job.
So her job is way less specific than yours. Yours is two things, very specific.
Wow.
Hers is everything else.
Just to make sure I'm able to help.
Do you have to have sex? Do you have to have sex? Is that part of your job? Do you have to have sex?
Oh, yes.
You
have to satisfy.
Provide dick. Provide dick.
I got to make sure at all times I'm ready.
Even if there's a time where you don't want to do it.
That's what that mean for a man.
Oh, I have that all the time. Like, me and my girl have that conversation. Like,
you're able to say no?
On the way back in the Uber? No, it's not. It's more like this. Like, yo, we fucking tonight? And then we're like, nah.
You're able to say that?
Hell yeah.
Can I ask you a question?
Y'all never have a mutual nah? You just had a big ass dinner, dessert. You full as fuck. You exhausted.
That's, I mean.
My ex.
It's never her going, oh my God, I want it so bad. I'm like, I can't. Then I got to go do it.
What you said. We both be like, we tired. Like, all
right. That's it.
When I touch you, you be like, or. Nah, not tonight. I'll be like, I ain't gonna lie. I go to sleep. I hate you.
Yeah, I'm not turning my back on her, but we'll both look at each other like, we need to get it in. Should we do it tomorrow in the morning when we got energy?
I ain't got time for
tonight,
the morning shit.
You can't do it in the morning. Oh, you waking up with Charlotte.
My rest of my day is fucked.
You're fucked.
The rest of the day fucked, bro.
Wait, if you fuck in the morning, the rest of your day is fucked?
Done.
Why?
You can't defer the dick. You gotta fuck when it's ready.
Yo, if I nut, I'm going to sleep.
Oh, you have, what?
I'm tired. It's
that's like your gasoline? That's like
You only do one time, too?
Oh, Taylor, stop
half
it.
Half a time.
Oh, Taylor, stop it.
Taylor is a wild girl, man.
What are you talking all the about?
Dick, this is why you're single. This is why you're single.
No.
You need too much dick.
That's a lot.
You need too much dick.
No, I have a high expectation. Sex drive. One round is not going to be
every time you say that, you're running man away. You're scaring him.
Yep.
Yeah. Yeah.
Man, if the one round is bomb.
I'm scared. My girls listen to this right now. I'm terrified. Give me the mask. Put that shit on Taylor.
That was a man,
cover this lady up. Yeah, I was a dude talking shit. Don't believe none of this.
But
come on,
y'all
now.
Are talking about how you discuss.
No good
your...
man is going more than one round. How do you have that kind of time?
Yo,
get a job.
That's not
get a
true.
Job. Buy you something.
That's
get a job.
True.
That's a great point.
That's
get a
not
job.
True.
He got no job,
if
Taylor.
Hanging
and why
out,
you not tired?
If we're talk-
why he hanging out? Why he got that kind of time?
Yo, why you not tired?
Can I ask you a question? Just so we keep it a buck
talk
right here.
Talk to me.
One round ahead isn't enough for me. I need multiple rounds.
Ooh.
Oh, fuck. All right.
Okay. Okay.
This girl is horny.
We gonna start it up like that.
Yeah. I really thought I had her. I thought I had her on the ropes, bro. I said one round ahead is not enough. She was like, gulp.
I lived in New York. They warmed that shit up.
But how y'all are talking, like, you talk to your partner about, like, oh, we're going to have sex tonight. My ex used to get mad at me if I used to bring up, like, you want to have sex.
Yeah, because you probably say it all the time.
No, I didn't. No, I didn't. Yeah. He would just be like.
You'd be having sex and she'd be like, yo, you want to fuck again? Yo, we should fuck after this, yo. This is kind of fun.
No,
I could do this
attitude.
All day. And I'm like, man, I'm trying to get the fuck out.
All now, day,
listen,
dog.
Spontaneous sex is great. Don't get me wrong.
It is. No,
but at the same time.
We're older.
We're older, yeah. We got responsibility. We know we're going to be busy tomorrow. Yo, we got to get it in today. Boom, let's go.
I know, but
I need to know if I got a shower.
My ex used to be upset with that.
Listen, if you going on vacation, y'all know what time it is. You ain't got shit to do all fucking day.
The best.
You can fuck all day. Just make sure you ain't got me nothing. As long as I don't nut, I can fuck you all throughout the whole fucking day.
Nah, that would drive someone
really?
Crazy. I'm surprised Carla's not pissed off at that shit.
What do you mean?
You just don't nut with her?
That's
just,
no, he does.
Listen,
he does.
If you want me to go all day, I'm just not going nut during these sessions.
As a kid, I mean.
Yeah, you be nutting, bro.
No, I'm not going nut during these sessions. Like, I do a session, you good? And then I keep on, if you want to fuck all day. But if you want me, if I let loose on any one of those, I'm done. I ain't got time.
You're done for the
shit,
day.
Man.
My you're a body. One nut per day guy.
Yes. You know how much fucking nut come on? It feel like fucking cup.
Ew.
It shit comes a lot.
I'm gonna be honest. I'm gonna be honest. When you say it, I believe it.
I'm trying to tell you, this shit's wild.
Now, when you got that mask, was it all black? Is that your jerk off mask?
Is that what you give your girl when it's time?
Just a little bit.
Just a little. One shot hits you and then you duck the next one. No, that's crazy. I think we got to have more realistic expectations for sex.
Yeah, you got to slow down.
I think your day doesn't have enough structure. You need a more structured day.
Yeah.
No, I'm talking about on the weekends, right? If I'm hanging out, overall, just hanging out.
Yep.
Right. Yeah, I want to have
you
a
don't got,
whole
you don't got
sex
no
session.
Friends to hang out with? I mean,
I
it's
do
just,
have friends
wild,
hang out
dude.
With.
What about brunch?
Yeah,
brunch
about
should count
it?
As sex one time. If we went to brunch
how long
together,
is that
we
sex
fuck.
Session? That's the real question.
Sex for me is anytime I pay for something or if I put my penis
no,
in
no, how
belt.
Long is it going?
Huh?
How long is it
because
going?
Because I'm acquiring, when I say sex session, I'm talking about head. Like all that, everything, not just
that
pumping.
Every
stuff.
Time?
Yeah, I think.
I just got woken up to head not too long ago. That shit was great.
You got woken up to head?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, dude, I'm not doing that.
And he went down for 15 minutes.
Guy doesn't make any real money. I'll tell you that right now. There's no way. No way.
Don't be mad because he went down for 15 minutes. Y'all can't.
15 minutes?
While
to
you,
go down?
He might have been down there for 4 hours. You have no fucking clue. You woke up at the end of it.
I didn't wake up to, like, we were, I was half up, whatever, and then.
You were half up or you were asleep? You said sleep. If you're snoring, farting
God.
And shit, he's down there.
That's wild. That's dangerous.
Right? You in the fucking splash
but you
zone,
only, listen,
bro.
Don't you know girls never even know when they're on their periods? Like, oh my God, you knocked it on. What if he was down there, your period came on that yeah. night?
Don't you hate when they blame us like God didn't make it every 28 days?
Good
right?
job. Like,
you fucking girl starts, oh, you must have started it. Oh, did I?
And you know what's crazy?
Oh, did I just start your body? Is that what happened?
Me. Fuck, I'm the Mr. Here. Lucky. And yeah. God, I used to think that, yeah. Oh, yeah, I did something.
It was supposed to be 2 weeks from now and I just knocked it down. Oh, I guess. Yeah.
He's pregnant by somebody else.
Well, Wax, you want to tell what happened with you this past week?
Wait, what happened with you, Wax?
Yeah, I have food poisoning, man.
From what?
I went somewhere. I went on a date. You know, Jubilee and Carlos is now starting our date night shit. And my first date night, I ended up with food poisoning.
Which day of the week?
I tried to do it like a Thursday, Friday. Oh, talk to me. Talk to me.
What?
Talk to
me.
Thursday, Friday, you competing with all the single people.
What?
No, that's literally with all.
Think
the
about
rounds.
It, right? Thursday, Friday, you compete with all the single people, right? Saturday, you compete with single people.
That's a lot. Saturday night is nuts.
Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, nobody's going out to dinner. Reservations much easier to get. Eat at the best restaurants.
I think about Mondays.
Wait,
man.
Say what?
I think about Mondays.
Monday, I do Tuesday, but like, why am I going to be out with all these fucking single people Fuck all that. I don't want to be around that shenanigans. I want to have a nice. I'm not trying to meet nobody. I got the girl that I want to meet.
And why does it matter if they're single or not? You got a pretty girl.
It's a bunch of single dudes. Pretty girl. You got. It's too much.
Yeah, yeah. There's a lot going on. No, I like to be quiet. Like we went to the movies a couple of weeks ago.
What movie you see?
Candyman.
No, he probably fell asleep during that shit. You don't know.
Baby, I went to sleep. You know what I'm saying? When I sit down, it's like time to.
I knew it.
I had a bunch of food.
I knew it.
Wax before.
Baby, you're boring, Wax.
What up? I can't finger you now. It's be too old for that shit. You know what I'm saying? It's been easy to fucking happen. Like, that's the reason why.
Now, hold on. This is Taylor. I need you to wait on this as well, but how long would y'all wait into the movie before trying to finger your date?
Back in the day?
Back in the day.
I was a fast finger.
Second preview.
This is the preview. Yo, this movie looks crazy.
I already got my hand on the lap.
You stick your hand in the butter popcorn.
that's way back in the day. That's your first kiss. You know what I'm saying?
That's your first kiss.
I remember the movie night fingering, bro. That was great. Has that ever happened? Did a guy ever tried to do that to you during a movie?
My boyfriend, but like,
I mean, I hope not some fucking random guy in seat 36.
Can I say that I'm not ambidextrous with my hands when it comes to fingering? Like, I can't finger with my left hand. Like, I've been like hooking up with girls on a bed, and they've been on like this side of me, and I've tried to do it, and it's almost like writing. Like, I don't have enough dexterity in these fucking fingers, so I gotta roll over them to the other side so I can finger with this hand. So if I'm in the movies and the only
what is
two,
this? Why this are you fingering?
But listen, you play the notes, bro.
Wait, what?
I'm lost.
When you finger a girl.
What are you? You're just doing this?
Yeah.
You're
don't
just playing for release on her vagina?
I never did that.
No. I didn't want to go this on fucking camera, but now you guys are making it happen. Yes, there's a little bit of that, right? But
yeah,
I can only do that with the right hand. I even right now with you guys, that's hard for me to do. Look at that.
It looks sturdy.
This one is not. This is.
He's got to practice.
Nah, your fluid would be better than sturdy,
right?
I assume,
here.
Right?
I'm right here. No, I got to go this one. Bop. What?
Yeah.
What? You're crazy, Till. This girl's crazy.
You got to practice.
All I'm saying is I only got one hand. So if a girl was sitting to the left of me in the movie theater, she not getting fingered. You're not getting fingered.
You're a very respectable date if she's on the right seat.
How the fuck am I supposed to cross over my body, get down under
can you
there?
Imagine asking how to switch two seats over? Hey, what do you want to...
Hey, baby, can you actually sit? She gets up to use the bathroom and I switch the seat because I know what's going on. That's the
Have
thing.
You ever got turned away by it? Like, she actually wants to watch the movie?
Nah.
I did. It was actually her friend. I tried to get two fingers in one night.
Wait, like one on each side of you?
Yes. So I was
what?
Like this and covers. I mean, like the jackets. I remember because I just got that jacket too. And she kept complimenting my race jacket. It was a new race jacket we got.
Okay.
Yeah, well, you finna finish, bitch.
Yeah. Oh, I was trying to finger both.
And then what happened?
She just grabbed my hand up under the jacket.
And like, one girl said no, but the other girl was cool.
She was already cool with it. I ended up kissing her under the night though.
Bill.
How long ago was this?
It's all about the jackets. I probably was like,
eight.
No, I was probably like 14, 15.
Oh my gosh.
Yeah.
Wild.
I thought you were going to say like at least 20, not 14.
What? You fingering 20 years old? Nah.
Yeah. God, I miss fingering.
Wait,
dude,
hold on.
You miss fingering at 20?
It was fun, dude.
It was fun time.
Hold on. Y'all don't finger at all, even during head?
You don't finger after you start having sex?
Yeah, I mean, it's like you can a little bit for warm up, but the thing about fingering is that like, I think it was so exciting when we were younger, because it's like that's when it became real, the sexual interaction. Like you're making out with a girl, like you're grabbing parts. It's like you're kind of hooking up, but you're not hooking. Like you can do that while you're dancing.
Touching the butt was a thing too.
Yeah, but like the finger was like, oh, we're gonna have sex.
Yeah, something about to happen.
Yeah, like this is gonna be real. It's
like,
very
like
exciting.
You opened a can or something.
Keep
you
going
get
that
little whiff.
Keep going on that.
Once you get that little whiff, it's like, okay, I can eat this.
Yeah. You get that whiff.
That's that albacore. That's Starkist.
Yeah.
Crank it open.
See how hard she's
back
been
in the day
dancing.
Too, baby. My girl not listening to that.
Okay. Taylor, what else we got, yo?
Okay. You about to say, like, all right.
For no reason.
For shit, do you guys want to talk about the R. Kelly convicted or no?
I mean, what do you think about R. Kelly?
So,
So that sounds great.
All right. So that's how I feel like, yes, he should get what he deserves, whatever, 140 years, whatever, how much he's getting. But at the same time.
Whoa.
Don't do that.
I'm just,
at the same time. Caveat. Like, and everyone's saying, oh, we got to cancel this music for real, blah, blah, blah. But like, what are we going to dance to? Like, at your wedding, what are we going to dance to? Like, Stepping Them in Love? What's going to replace that?
Frankie Lyman.
Akash had an interesting point about this, though.
I believe he does not own his masters. So you can still listen to R. Kelly without giving any money back
to R. Kelly. He doesn't own his masters at all?
I believe not.
So I think
I heard that once and I didn't want to fact check it because I don't want to be wrong. And I just want to enjoy R. Kelly's music.
But here's the tricky thing about R. Kelly's music.
I got let off the hook, morally.
R. Kelly wrote the music.
Yeah.
Those old songs that, like, a composer would write, and then you just have the most famous people of the time
sing them.
Like, a Frank Sinatra would just sing the hits, etc.
Yeah.
Like, I feel like you could still like that song no matter what, because that person just sang it. They didn't write it.
Mm-hmm.
And if the meaning for you is, like, what the song is about, then you could probably listen to it. You'd be okay. But R. Kelly wrote all this shit.
I know.
And he meant it.
And you're right, though. Akasha says.
So who else is like in R. Kelly's shoes that we still listen to who did bad?
Who did bad, 100% confirmation?
Yes.
All of them?
Not this bad?
Hitler.
Well, I mean, I don't listen to Hitler's hits, you know?
I bet that shit was good, though.
He'll talk about it though.
You know. I'm not listening to that.
I learned about fucking Hitler. Why the fuck I need to learn about him?
But I don't think he was a musician. He was an artist. He was an artist.
Who else?
Like, who else is just as bad as R. Kelly, but we still watch his stuff?
Yes.
I mean, well, Woody Allen married
his daughter.
His wife's adopted daughter.
Yeah.
Which is close enough.
It's still weird.
It's very weird.
Elvis Presley.
His wife adopted the door. No,
he married like a
third. Hold on. One combo at a time. So, the Woody Allen thing?
No, he's not. Yeah, it all depends on the age now.
She was young. When they met.
That's
she
different
then. Yeah.
I mean, I think she was 19.
Yeah.
When they met?
I think they met for the first time at 17, but they lived in separate homes. Or maybe the first time they met, she was 19 or something like that. And like, I'm not trying to cap for him. It's fucking weird and he should know that it's weird and just not do it.
Yeah.
Even if that's the person you love more than anybody in the world, marry the second person you love more than anybody in the world. Like, not everybody gets their first chance or first choice in life.
He married his wife's stepdaughter.
No, his wife's adopted daughter.
Yeah.
Wow.
So wait, he married his wife. She had a 17-year-old adopted daughter at the time. And then 2 years later, he left his wife for this girl?
I don't know the exact timeline of when he left.
Yeah.
But I know that he wasn't apparently in her life as much as we assume. I assume they all lived in one big house. Everybody's happy.
You assume.
But the wife lived in a separate house.
Doesn't it kind of
like, he wasn't a father figure. Say again.
Like Chris like that.
Oh, yeah. He looks a little like Chris. Yeah.
Didn't Chris marry an Asian girl?
Yeah. Oh, Chris trying to run it back. One time.
For the culture.
Chris actually probably knows the details of this. Hey, Chris, are you on with us?
Yeah, but I'm not. I don't have anything to say about it. I don't know what you guys are talking about.
Yo, Chris, come on. Don't leave us hanging out here. You know what happened with Woody. Talk to us.
Listen, if you want a better comparison to R. Kelly, I would suggest Jimmy Page, the guitarist for Led Zeppelin, who in his 50s was married to like a 17-year-old woman. Jerry Lee Lewis, the early rock star who married a 13-year-old Elvis. Those are probably closer comparisons.
Elvis married?
What was her name?
Priscilla?
Priscilla Lee. Yeah, she was only, she was definitely a minor.
I think he met her at like 14, apparently. Wouldn't have sex with her until she turned like 16 or something like that. Like, but yeah, that's fucking disgusting.
Yeah.
Yeah. They're all monsters. I didn't know that. What, Jimmy Page, who married a 13-year-old?
Come on, bro.
Yeah, Jimmy Page was infamous for dating essentially teenagers.
Yeah, these people are absolute creeps. Why won't you talk about the Woody Allen thing? Just out of curiosity.
Oh, no, I just heard you guys comparing. I didn't know what you're talking about, but I think you pretty much nailed the details of it. It was Mia Farrow's adopted daughter, and they claimed they didn't start having an intimate affair until after he had broken up with Mia. And he also claims that during the time he was technically her father or stepfather, they were living apart in separate houses, like you say. But I think you nailed it. even if this is the person you love in the most in the world, marry the second one, right? Like, yeah. There's just no scenario where it's kosher, essentially, to get in a relationship.
It's like also kind of arrogant to just assume you should marry the person that you love the most in the world. Do you know what I mean? Like, there's a lot of people who go, I love Beyonce the most in the world.
Yeah,
but I don't get to marry Beyonce.
That's a good point.
Jay-Z marries Beyonce. So then you start going down the list until you get someone that you can have. Mm. And yeah, your wife's adopted daughter.
You think she was upset?
Who, the wife or the daughter?
The wife.
I mean, yes, I think so.
Wife.
But to be clear, the big allegation, even more so than that against Woody Allen, is that he actually sexually abused his birth daughter when she was like one or two. And that's what's really the source of controversy, even more so than marrying his stepdaughter.
They've investigated that a bunch. And like, I think even like the CIA or FBI or something like looked into it and they're like, nah, this is not legit.
Yeah, there's a whole doc. I haven't watched it, but I mean, certainly you can go down that rabbit hole.
Yeah, that's the thing. It's got to be 100% if you're going to put that on.
Yeah, screen. Don't do that.
And also, I think like the Mia Farrow, the woman who his like wife, like I think three of her adopted kids ended up dying from either like suicide or drug overdose.
Jesus. Why would they keep giving her kids?
Say what?
Why do you keep giving her kids?
They just do that with rich white women. That's just a thing. If you're a rich white woman, you just get
rich
to...
Rich white women can get anything they want. Yeah. This is the rule.
Yeah,
you didn't know how kids. America was built?
No, yeah.
They put a woman on the coin.
They did?
Yeah, Susan B. Anthony.
Oh, yeah.
Never even knew that.
Yeah. She wasn't president. She was anything.
She couldn't even have a job to get the coins, probably.
She was sewing a flag or something.
You know what?
Betsy Ross. That wasn't even her.
Betsy Ross. At least she, you put her on the bill. Like, what was she doing to be on the money?
Huh?
Let me see the change.
I got no change.
No, it's on like the dollar coin or something like that.
Yeah.
But what did Susan B. Anthony do?
Price fund good.
I don't honestly think she deserves a middle initial. That's Susan Anthony.
Yeah. Anthony, champion of
these are rights temperance, activists.
Abolition, the rights of labor, and equal pay for equal work. Actually, that's kind of lit.
Yeah, she wasn't fighting for people.
First feminist, basically.
Ah, bro.
Respect. Man,
and now wax sells masks made out of her. So this is a real compliment. All right. Shout out to Susan B. Anthony. She
it's so crazy how they posed back in the day in the pictures.
Right?
Proper.
Like, look how we pose now versus.
Yes.
Like,
they
also, had, like, back proper. In the day, if you were painting me and my family, like, the audacity of you to make it accurate.
What? Yeah, 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 like, no,
put a
I agree.
Filter on, you piece of shit.
Do some
this
Photoshop.
Gonna forever, like they don't even know what I look like for real, for real.
I don't pay you for accuracy.
Yeah, you making my wife look like this so everybody knows I like these big chicks.
Yeah,
you know what I mean? Slim it up.
Yeah. Yo, look how long.
Do a little air
museum.
A little airbrushing.
That's it.
Look how long you had to sit there and pose for pictures.
Exactly.
Back in the day.
Yeah,
hours. Somebody sit there and draw you out the whole time.
I'm a walk in the room, like, make me and my family look as beautiful as possible. And I'm going to help you do that by not being here.
Yep.
So you just pick some people that we should look like, and that's it for history. Because that's all we know of old people, right?
Yeah.
Like, all we know about George Washington and shit is how he looked in that one picture.
That's it.
I got one idea of George Washington. He had a bad hair day. His shit wasn't curling sometimes.
Yeah, for real.
Right? Like, imagine George Washington came back and he was telling people he's George Washington, but his perm is all fucked up. And you're like, man, that ain't
lying.
You.
Santa Claus. Yeah. Santa Claus had a dope beard all these fucking years.
Okay. So was controversial stuff happening on like the Shade Room and stuff where you know who Ari Fletcher is?
No, who's Ari Fletcher?
Ari and Moneybagg Yo. Do you know who that is?
Yeah.
Kind of. Okay.
Well, that's the girlfriend of Moneybagg Yo, Ari Fletcher. She used to date G Herbo.
I'm like nobody.
And basically he brought her, or she brought him, 28 acres.
Oh, we spoke about this. I love it.
Yeah.
It's dope.
I think this is so
cool. Dope.
But did you see what the girls from The Real said about
what they said?
What they said?
Alex, this is the first link under shit you won't care.
So who bought who? She bought him or he bought her?
She bought him 28 acres of land in Memphis, which sounds great.
Wow. And basically, they were trying to say that that's wifey duties and she's only a girlfriend. So I don't believe that. I don't agree.
That's dope girl duty.
Yeah. I mean, what a great...
So keep pushing the arrow and you'll see what they said.
That's fire.
That's her kind of coming back at her. She made a good point.
Let me see.
Should there be limits placed on gifts in your relationship when you are not married?
Last season, Lonnie and I were talking about don't act married if you're not married. This is acting married. That's
Can you pause this for a second?
Yeah, I hate this fucking...
I, I need to see the same energy when these girls are talking about buy me a Birkin.
Exactly. Like,
where's the same energy, right?
Like, sweetie that, out man? Here getting fucking luxury.
Girls get a Birkin, you get jewelry, you get watches, all
go
these
ahead,
things.
Go ahead, girl, get him,
the
girl.
Bentley.
I'm not on hubby duty, right? Yeah. Why am I acting like a husband when I do that?
We always doing husband duty, always.
And can I be honest? This is what's
pay
annoying.
The bill?
Facts, bro. This is what's annoying about these girls talking shit about this. We were talking about this on Flagrant too, but this is like, this is a gift that can provide generational wealth.
Exactly.
And it is something that should be rewarded no matter what. Like, giving people an asset that's just going to grow in
come
value.
Come on, man.
Like, what a cool gift.
God bless you,
it's
girl.
A really cool gift.
A car depreciates every boom. Single day.
Every day.
I used to think like that, though. Not necessarily off her, but, like, I used to think that there used to be wife duties. And
how you going to be wife if you don't do wife duties? You're going to stay girlfriend forever.
There's certain... No, you just got mad. No, you got to match the guy's forever. Energy. If the guy's energy is not... up to par, then I'm not gonna
yeah, but
do
we can't assume
things.
That for him. We don't know how
of
he
course,
treats
us. Of course, I know. I'm saying based, not exactly. based off them. I'm just saying for me, like, I used to not real. Do certain
is
things.
Is there anything that a husband's supposed to not do? Because we do literally everything all the way throughout. Nothing changes for us. We still take care of everything throughout.
Yep.
Like, are you going to do anything different when you get married?
No.
No, I've been same. Treating my girl like my wife.
What the fuck am I going to do?
I don't, yeah. I don't treat her
what
any
more
differently.
What can I do? Get yelled at, shut up, and lose.
Once a week.
That's it out loud. I'm going to therapy, y'all. I'm going to therapy. I'm learning.
That's so why stupid. He wants to yell at his therapist, just to get it back.
I'm so stupid.
You want me to lose again?
That's my problem, because I still fight.
Yeah,
like
loser.
I still try to win
you're
the argument.
You're bugging.
You do?
I know. I do.
You're going to lose anyway.
Now I do, but I'm like that in life. Like, I just,
that's
you know.
A bigger present, bro.
That's me. That's just
you gotta get the last.
I never understood married men who were like, pick your battles, and now I'm like, oh, I get. There's so many things. It's like, oh, this one you can have this one, and then when it's worth it, we can fucking go.
Every battle, it could be the littlest thing.
Oh my god,
fucking thing.
She's going to end up winning anyway.
Oh, I know, but it's just I don't know why. There's something in me that just compels to fucking argue. This happens all. If I see something that is like karmically off in the universe, I have to correct that every single time.
You learn.
No,
that's childish, yo.
Yeah, I'm a child.
That shit is childish.
Yeah, I'm a fucking child. That is.
Yo, you got a lot of fucking liquid.
What do you mean?
Because my mouth is too dry to do all that.
To do all the arguing? Oh, I can argue all day.
You
I love
you
it.
Got water next to you or something? What the fuck is that shit right there?
I got the white shit building up my fucking corner of my mouth. I don't care.
It's
I'm ready to roll.
Fucking way
smoke
I'm doing
coming
that.
Out of my mouth. I'm ready to
she
argue.
She won.
Dude. Say what?
She won.
No.
She's like, let's talk. I said, you already won. So whatever it is.
No, I don't. No, I think you gotta. If you think that you're in the right, you gotta. Now, if I'm wrong, I'll say it.
Me too. That's what we do.
I'll say it right off the.
So then, what are you arguing?
Well, because she don't admit she's wrong.
That's why.
So now I gotta get her. And then, if you're gonna not admit you're wrong for so long, now it's a thing. When you are wrong, I need to see it. And it could be about the littlest. Yo, it could be about the littlest shit, bro. It could be, it could be her saying, yeah, I turned off the light in the room already. And I go back in there. I'm like, the light's not off. And she's like, oh, that's weird. I turned it off. And I'll be like, no, you didn't.
Got you.
Say you didn't. I need you to admit it. Sometimes there's a problem with the system. It turns back on. Don't do that.
Oh,
the system. I know you blame it on the system for no fucking reason.
This is great.
I need that.
I need this.
I need that.
Because you know what? They make us own up to it. Yep. I ain't got time for them to make them own up to it. I ain't got time for that shit.
I like an argument.
You could, yeah, man.
I, this is something that has not gone away with age. It actually has increased with age. I like an argument.
You know
not
what I'm
necessarily
really
my girl,
about?
But just in life, I like a fuck. Dude, the other day I was at we were at this place, Sedell's, right? It's it's just like a fancy like bagel and like cream cheese and like lox spot, okay? Yeah. And I take my mom, my dad, and I take my girl, and we all go, right? Mm-hmm. And they sit us at this table that's like right under the AC, and the AC is like blowing down my fucking head and neck. And I asked the guy, I'm like, hey man, can we switch tables? The AC is blowing down. And the guy, the waiter, like kind of like rolls his eyes. And I look and I'm like, oh, are you telling me at a Jewish restaurant, nobody's ever switched the fucking table that they were put down here? Like, you should be the most aware of this, right? Yes. In fact, you sat us at this fucking table because you think that I'm not Jewish and you think you could sit us under the AC. So I move it, and I swear to God, all the other Jewish people around, they look at me and they're like, good for you. You stood up for yourself. Good for you. Nobody sits at that table. They were so proud that I actually moved my... Like, I protected my family. Like, I took care of them. But I like the argument.
But you know what I'm mad at? That you don't sound like me? and I can put you on the phone and you go ahead and do all the arguing.
Yeah. Well, on the phone you can do it, but in person it looks more intimidating.
I love, as I get older, walking away from an argument. Like when they're pissed off, like she's mad, and I'm like, yeah, we're not doing this. And then I just walk off and just leave a minute.
You can do that too? What the fuck?
Oh, it's a bigger fight later. But I'm fine with that. Because in the moment, you just sit in your anger. Sometimes it'll level off. Most of the time, no. But it's like, I'm not doing this.
I can't. Matter of fact, if I start a fight, and then we get into a fight, and then she's still upset after we've resolved the fight, we gonna fight about that. Fuck you upset about? We just resolved it. I said sorry. I took accountability. I apologize. I was cranky. That's on me. Now you cranky.
I'm getting the fuck out of here if I can.
Nah. Yeah.
Y'all got some
what
balls.
The hell, Charlie?
I need to go.
The fuck is wrong?
I need to go. Shout out to Tequila Queen. Yo, this is my boy Style Better. This is what I need for my arguments with my girl. Just an energy drink.
Do you think you do that too, though? Because you find maybe like content for your jokes and stuff like that. Like,
nah, not even, man. Not even.
I don't think you go through life looking for content.
Yeah, that's joy.
Okay.
One of the nice things about being a comic is when something horrible happens to you, you go, oh, at least this can be material. Peace. But you're not going through life looking for horrible. At least not for me.
Yeah.
But like when something incredibly embarrassing happens, you're like, oh, this is going to be good.
Yeah.
This is going to be good. Yeah. I don't know. I can't believe you don't get into an argument.
I can't take it. I hate arguing because she's going to win anyways. Like, you know, that's like playing against somebody and you in a wheelchair and against basketball.
Is it because...
You know what I'm saying? You know you guarantee going to lose.
Is it because maybe he's the only one with a white significant other?
Oh, that's what I think it is.
I mean, I'm going up against a fucking battle axe, dog. Like, I don't want this. I don't want this yelling, bro. Oh,
a tourist Puerto Rican.
It's too much, yo.
With curly hair.
T-O-R-E-S.
Yes.
Yeah.
All right, guys, we're going to take a break for a second because after years of fine print contracts and getting ripped off by big wireless providers, we've learned something very important. And it's that there's always a catch. So when I first heard about Mint Mobile and the fact that they're offering premium wireless services at just $15 a month, I thought, well, what's the catch? There must be a catch. But after speaking with them and using their service, it all made sense. There isn't one. Mint Mobile's secret sauce is that they're the first company to sell wireless service online only. Okay? By cutting out the retail stores, there's no crazy overhead costs that get passed down to you in the form of mystery fees. Okay? Instead, Mint just passes on sweet savings direct to you. I'm telling you, this is the best and most affordable option in the business. It's amazing what you can get done when you don't have that brick and mortar that you got to pay for over and over and over again. This is the one that you use. It's for people looking for extra savings. Mint Mobile offers premium wireless for just $15 a month. I know that seems unreal, but it's not. There is no catch. All plans come with unlimited talk and text, high-speed data delivered on the nation's largest 5G network. Use your own phone with any Mint Mobile plan and keep your same phone number along with all your existing contacts. I mean, that's absolutely crazy. It's so convenient to go over to Mint Mobile. And if you're not 100% satisfied, Mint Mobile has you covered with their 7-day money-back guarantee. Switch to Mint Mobile and get premium wireless service starting at just $15 a month, okay? To get your new wireless plan for just $15 a month and get the plan shipped to your door for free, go to mintmobile.com/idiots. That's mintmobile.com/idiots. Cut your wireless bill to $15 a month at mintmobile.com/idiots. Now, this episode is also brought to you by Upstart. What would you do if you didn't have high interest loans or credit card debt? With Upstart, you can pay off your existing debt quickly and easily and start living your life. Upstart is the fast and easy way to pay off your debt with a personal loan all online. Whether it's paying off credit cards, consolidating high interest debt, or funding personal expenses, over a million people have used Upstart to get one fixed monthly payment with a clear payoff date. Rather than looking at a credit score alone, Upstart considers other factors like your income, current employment, and credit history to find you a smarter rate for your loan. You can check your rate without impacting your credit score in minutes for loans between $1,000 to $50,000, okay? You can even receive funds as fast as one business day after accepting your loan. Find out how Upstart can lower your monthly payments today when you go to upstart.com/idiots. That's upstart.com/idiots. Don't forget to use our URL to let them know that we sent you. Loan amounts will be determined based on your credit, income, and certain other information provided in your loan application. Upstart.com/idiots. Now let's get back to the show.
All right. Did you hear about Will Smith?
What happened, Will Smith?
He came out and said that he cheated too.
No way.
After though, right? Yeah. No, the timeline is important. It's after.
Yo, bro.
It's after. But they said that in that thing.
They said that he was thinking about hooking up with.
Your girl fucks around on you. Everybody finds out. First. And then you got to be like,
well, we all do it. I did it too. Yeah.
She probably made him do that too. Jada rotten, yo.
He said that he was trying to, he was thinking about going with Halle Berry. Like doing.
He should have.
Yeah, all right.
Me too.
Yeah. What the fuck you want to sit there and say? It's not entanglement. What
does that even mean, thinking? I've been thinking a lot.
You've been thinking about that shit.
I've been thinking about fucking Marilyn Monroe. Too bad she dead. But I've been thinking about it. Like, what does that even mean? Is that how you threaten your girl like that? Girl, I've been thinking, yo.
I'll go over there. I'll go fuck Rihanna right now.
Yeah. Okay.
I heard he fucked Margot Robbie, though.
Word?
Yeah, that's what I heard.
Business out there?
I heard that was a thing, yo.
Damn, man.
Yo, that August shit must have really fucked him up for him to be going out there.
Oh, 100%, dog.
He got fat.
Yeah.
Remember?
Yeah.
He tried to blame it on the pandemic. All right. All right. August. How is any famous person's
pandemic
life
of cheating ass wives? That's the pandemic.
That's really what it is. Ouch. Your life as a rich person ain't any different in the pandemic, right? You stay in your house, private. Mm-hmm. Your house is huge. You got
compound in Calabasas.
Got everything personal you need. Trainer, chef,
backyard crazy.
Yo, famous people that get fat, fuck you.
Yeah.
Fuck you, you lazy pieces of shit. You have every opportunity not to get fat.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You have a private chef and workout trainer.
You just gave up?
Yeah, you're right.
You have no excuse.
Maybe they don't like to work out, though.
Yeah, fuck you.
Will Smith loves working out. Will Smith will die on a treadmill. Those are his words. I will die on a treadmill.
Like to swim?
Yes, he will.
Yeah.
Now.
Yeah. Don't put that bitch up above 6.
Yeah. Nah, but, I mean, listen, Will Smith is the fucking king, bro. I love Will. Like, he's the goddamn man. It just sucks that they even got to be open about their relationship. Like, this is hurtful.
It is all hurtful.
It is hurtful.
And the fact that he has to do damage control for her, get the fuck. I'm Will Smith.
No.
I'm the famous one.
Why do you think that she's famous too?
She's sloppy.
She's not famous like him. No fucking chance she's famous like him.
No, of course not. I'm not saying. Yeah, she's famous.
She's famous. She's Will Smith's wife. That's why she's famous.
Jada famous.
What, you watch Woo? You really watched Woo?
I did.
Jada, you watched Hawthorne on TNT?
Hold on. What has Jada done for Will?
We have know babies. What Will. That, take care of him.
No, y'all are not about to do that to
take
Jada,
care of his
yo.
Kids. Take care of the house. Turn her head when he have sex with other women for years.
She don't got to turn her head. It's already sucking on another man.
Yeah.
Oh, my God.
She turned her head first.
I'll get to see what the fuck you done did.
This guy can't eat a whole. You got a name of a fucking guy named after a month? He now this guy August. Spends a whole month pissed off. Yeah. Just waiting for September.
A great month. Summer.
A great month.
Motherfucker, even enjoy summer.
It's his birthday.
You know
it's,
exactly.
August.
His birthday's in August.
Oh my God, yo.
Nah, that's crazy.
But nah, yeah.
Right, but listen, for real, if your girl or your wife cheat on you, what the hell do you do?
If wait, what is that?
Will must got like some. He like got. He's so strong to be able to stay around. Your wife cheat on you. What the fuck?
Yo,
you
he's the king, bro. I love.
No,
Will.
But they Will's said. The man. Look, they said the in the interview that they can't be in like a prison in their marriage. So she never won a convention. She was unconventional with marriage. Like she didn't really want to get married.
Man, cut all that out, yo.
That's what
but you got mad.
No, but she has said that in the past, though. She said that in the past.
What's unconventional? Not having sex with somebody else.
You know what's unconventional? Getting to marry Will Smith. You got your unconventional marriage. Yeah. You married the greatest man in America.
Wow.
That's not conventional.
He ran a marathon.
That? Yeah, sure. I think a lot of people do that. But yeah.
That's not the most impressive thing.
No? This guy used to save the earth every summer.
Yeah.
Every summer, this motherfucker saved the world.
Literally is a superhero.
Man.
Like, come on, yo.
Okay, and guess what? She knows how to, like, you know, hold guns.
You can't even name a movie. You can't.
Hello, Set It Off.
You hear what she
That's
said?
Like one of my favorite movies.
Oh, she was one of the four leads in Set
and
It
she
Off.
She made it.
Hoorah.
All of her friends passed away.
What? That's the writer, bro. You talking about the ending of the
Will
movie,
Smith
like that makes her a star.
Husband already. dud. Why do you think she survived?
Was she in Poetic Justice?
Yeah.
Yes.
Yes.
Will Smith was already her husband.
With Tupac. No, Will Smith was her husband. That was when she was with Tupac, the only man she ever loved.
Yo.
Yo, I hate y'all, yo. And she was on Girls Trip.
Yo, imagine not Janet and another girl.
Son, this
that didn't help.
She was friends with the girl that fucked Tupac in the postal truck. Right?
No,
her and Pop was a love story.
Janet Jackson, you talking about?
She wasn't.
Oh, Janet Jackson was Poetic Justice. She wasn't even Poetic. She was Jason's lyric. Get out of here, dude.
Yeah, she was Poetic. She was Jason's lyric. I don't know.
She was lyric.
But yeah, let's just keep it a buck. Will is, Dina. This is why this is so hard for us to like settle this equation, because we see Will as this massively successful actor, superhero, just superstar.
Last name,
we don't think that he has to sacrifice in a way that his wife is out there banging other dudes. Yikes. Right? We think a guy of that stature should be able, if he wants to, not saying it's right or wrong, but he should be able to have five wives that are all faithful to him
because
he's that successful. And now he's decided to marry this girl and spend his life with this girl who is, objectively speaking, less successful than him.
Yeah.
And he still got to allow her to fuck other dudes.
Ouch.
That seems unfair. But in our brains, it seems unfair. But maybe they have something.
Yeah. I would say, I feel like they've been open yourself, marriages. Bro. And, like, I was listening to her Red Table Talk, like, old ones.
Oh, you mean her Damage Control? Go ahead. Sorry.
Oh, my God.
That shit is all PR, though. It drives me crazy, but go ahead.
So. I enjoy them. So
go. You're allowed to.
So, and she was saying how, like, y'all think about Will Smith being so successful, but what about his personality? She was saying that he was controlling, not necessarily controlling, but, like, he was trying to make too much perfect instead of just kind of, like...
Yeah, real monster. Sounds like a real monster.
Oh, my God.
Well, listen, don't you know, if you that successful, you expect you to be able to have something for yourself. I want to be able to have my own car, my own
what
house.
What does he control?
My own wife.
He's a Virgo, man. But what does he control?
Oh, he's a Virgo, too.
His kids do whatever the fuck they want, right?
Come on.
Like, you can't be a controlling parent and then your kids are that fluid and, like, dress whatever they want. Dude, like, a controlling parent is like, this is your haircut. This is how you dress. This is the school you go to. Like, this is the life that you're going to live. Like, my parents weren't controlling at all. They were way more controlling than that. My dad's not letting me walk around dressed like that. You out of your mind?
I couldn't even play football.
Come on, yo. You think Will Smith's
You're talking about father. I'm talking about
also, is it
husband.
Controlling to say you can't have dicks inside you that aren't mine? That's
no,
controlling?
No, that's not how she was saying
That's
it.
The only problem. That's what we're hearing.
Oh, my God.
If that's controlling, I'm controlling. I'm a tyrant.
I'm really a control freak. Like, what the fuck? You know, old boy, what's the guy with the beads in his hair? The rapper.
Lil Yachty?
Yeah. Lil Yachty.
He said, you're a child if you want to know if what's your girls count.
You are.
I'm a child of God, for sure. You're bugging. I want to know what the hell.
You want to know how many bodies?
You want to know, if you go to a car, you want to know how many Carfax?
I don't want to know.
You don't want to know the Carfax?
Because if I already love the car, don't tell me how many motherfuckers rode it.
Miles.
I love it.
What if it was an Uber?
Say what?
What if it's an Uber? And then you finally wonder why it's breaking down. Like, damn, if I knew this, I see in 10 miles, this shit was going to break down and have problems.
But I love it.
Bipolarness, so and that's all up. That type of energy. She's got it from all the other type of different type of people.
Mm-hmm.
It's going to be all in you, too.
Yeah.
Have fun.
I know. It's fucked up.
That smell, that gum under the seat from the third person. The nut stain from the number six. You know what I'm saying? The fucking, the Burger King spill on the floor that they never got up.
I like how
Keep going.
I like how he went from metaphor to the real thing. He's like, the gum under the seat. You're like, I know what that is. He goes, and then the nut stain. Okay, we're being literal.
Then
too.
Back to Burger King.
Back to Burger King. I hear what you're saying. I think that makes complete sense. But my feeling with relationships is ignorance is bliss. Like, I don't want to know nothing about your past before me. And I don't want to tell you anything about mine because I know it's just going to create conflict.
You like, think, why would she still be upset with something?
My girl wants to know how many bodies I got. And I'm like, no, you're not having that conversation.
How would a man know?
Yeah, I got to count that.
A man not supposed to know, a woman's supposed to know.
No.
How many bodies
true.
She got?
For sure.
Absolutely.
That's not true.
That's what I'm saying.
If a guy goes, I don't want to know, we're really saying, we really want you to go, it's not even that many. And then we go, all right, how many?
I don't want to know. And they say, and then they go like, I can count it on one hand. Like, but if she says some shit like, good, be like, hey, what do you mean good?
So y'all don't think the stuff that they're doing to you, like during sex, they didn't learn from someone else, another guy?
No.
It okay, but not 50, not 70.
One other guy.
One guy who was really good at sex. Yeah. He taught her all the moves.
Just hope he's not wax. Timberlands on her?
I do.
Nah, dude. It's fucked up. It's vulnerable, I see, for a girl, because like, I remember I dated a girl once, and then she said, what she wanted to do was, what is it called when somebody watches you?
Cuckold.
She was like, I want you to watch me get fucked by someone.
That's all.
What? She said that to you?
Which is super disrespectful that you would, like, that you were even comfortable enough to say that to me. Like, why would you think I was going to be like, yo, me too. That'd be dope. Like,
I was just thinking about
that. I just get to sit here. And if y'all need a towel or water or something, I just go break.
No, like, you are the one that's supposed to say that.
Say what?
Oh, that's kind of disrespectful. You say that to her too, though.
I'm not saying that to her.
Nobody.
That's
way more disrespectful to himself.
Yeah. But it was crazy. Like, she was saying it, and I was like, hey, wait, hold on. Like, the way she said it, it was like, I want to do like a threesome, like two guys, like, and then me or something like that. And I'm like, wait, did you get that wrong? Like, like I literally,
one plus one is,
yeah, I was like, hold on, wait, what do you mean by, you mean like two girls? And then, because I'm like, why would you be saying this to me?
Yeah.
Right, like I was so confused, I couldn't believe that you would be this crazy and disrespectful. So like, I was like, "You had two girls, son." I was getting hype. I was like, "Did this girl just say her dream is a threesome? Like, let's get it. Me too.
I'm down."
Shorty goes, "No, like two guys, or like you could watch me have sex with a guy." And I was like, "Yo, what is happening? Like, what happened before this to make you feel comfortable?"
You did something to make her think it was okay.
Yes.
You did something to make her think this guy would want to watch me get fucked.
Yeah, like, what
you need to retrace your own steps that night.
I started racking my brain. I was like, what the fuck?
When last time you nutted early since that happened?
I don't know, but maybe I was listening too much. I think there's some imbalance in the relationship where she got so comfortable. She was like, yo, you should watch another guy fuck me. And then she looked at me as if I was about to be like, she wasn't even embarrassed.
Wait, hold on. Like, how long were y'all together before she told you?
No, we weren't together. We were just fucking around or whatever. Yeah. But like,
that's
how trash is your dick game?
Yeah. Like, I just finished fucking you. She's like, my dream is someone else fucks me. Like,
and you take notes in the corner.
Yeah. That's crazy disrespectful, yo. How you gonna disrespect me like that? Right? Dumbass girl.
That's even funnier than
that. Now that I say it in front of y'all, that's tragic.
No, I didn't know you just finished fucking.
Yo, I literally just finished fucking. I'm thinking, I'm the man, so I'm still looking at myself in the mirror. I got the mirror attached to the fucking closet. I'm like, yo, boy out here killing it. And she's like,
after sex, he said that?
Yeah, probably.
That's bad.
Yeah.
She's probably still in the mood, though. A little horny mood, make girls say anything.
No. I'm not gonna say that.
Trying to help you out.
I know you were. I know you were, bro. I guess I didn't lay it down, man. Fuck. Or maybe it was so intimate that she really thought she could share everything. I think I even said that shit. I think I looked at it, I was just like, why would you say that to me? Like, I was just so confused.
Can you count all your times it was like real good, or you count your worst times ever in life?
What, in sex?
Yeah. Can you count your good, the best times?
I can't count good or bad. I can't
count
good or
bad. I definitely can't count bad. That shit is innumerable.
I'm trying to think of like really bad ones. Like I've had like hilariously bad ones.
Yeah, I have hilarious bad ones.
Like, I had one where...
I need to know.
Oh man, this girl, it was this bomb ass Brazilian girl, bro. I was young. I was like in college, like fire ass Brazilian chick. Like, and this is when you're younger, and I hadn't slept with a Brazilian girl. You just know about like the Brazilian models from Victoria's Secret. So like you already add 2 points onto a Brazilian. Yeah. Like if you got a Brazilian, you're like, I gotta do it.
Yeah. Just don't know what they cook.
And we started fucking, and I nutted so fast, right? I just kept fucking. Like, the nut is in the condom. I kept fucking. I started getting soft. I pulled out. No condom. The condom is just in the pussy still. So I had to be like, I left something. And I had to go back in there.
Oh, my God.
Pull the condom out. That's embarrassing.
The wrong size.
Say what?
They're the wrong size.
What do you mean, the condom?
Yeah.
It's always the wrong size when you're soft.
Insert cricket.
You say so. Are you in there?
Yo, shut up, Wax. Motherfucker, soft economy. A tourniquet on your soft dick. Fuck out of here, Wax.
I'm sorry.
I'm sorry. Y'all are crazy, yo. Y'all never had girls with tight pussies before?
Taylor about to ask you to watch her fuck her boyfriend.
Y'all never had girls with tight pussies before?
Yeah. It suctioned off. Okay.
Yeah.
Oh.
What do you think happened?
I don't know. I thought you just fell off.
You never had a girl like say I snatched condoms off?
Never.
You never?
She said she snatched condoms off.
This is like a girl's bragging line. Like,
yes.
I can snatch it off.
Oh, yeah. Kegels.
Kegels.
Yeah, Kegels.
Oh, now it's flipped.
No.
Now the girl's pussy's so strong, they pulling the condoms off.
Yeah.
What? That can happen?
If it's tight enough. Or, no, most of the time you have the wrong size.
I'm about to say, what type of fucking Kegels girls
no,
is this?
But it is, I mean, it's possible.
So you're telling me the girl pussy could do this?
Let me tell you this. If I am soft inside a girl and I have a condom on and she wants to squeeze her pussy,
yeah,
she can take a condom right the fuck off.
All right, but what's the question? She squeezes it.
Or you guys haven't been with tight pussy before. I don't know what to tell you. But if a girl can't take a condom off your soft dick, I don't know what to tell y'all, bro.
You really trying to tell y'all, bro.
Well, you must got a lot of girls who work out.
Nah, just a Brazilian one.
Okay, Kegels. I would never find out about Kegels now.
Okay,
married.
Now y'all just fucking made me feel horrible.
But don't you
remember
know,
I was telling you about comedy and life and the horrible things that happen to you end up becoming funny things and everybody gets to laugh at you
do
for
you can't ask you about like when you get embarrassed during sex, do you like apologize to the girl like I'm sorry, it's just
she
I
said
got
it when like it happens all the time.
And I'm not great. Saying it happens.
Charlamagne, come back.
But we all have seasons, I promise you. Cause I go through my season. I'm not early. Like, everybody not all year round, you just every single time, like, you the man. Out of a year, I probably give you, say if you have sex 100 times, 13 times not early.
Nutting, this is the fucked up thing about nutting
early. Out of 100.
Nutting early
Baker's
is...
Baker's dozen.
Yeah. this is the thing about nutting early. Nutting early is just, it's not an amount of time. It's just an amount of time before you nut.
Yes.
That's the thing that's fucked
worse.
About early. It's like, if you come, it's never early. See what I'm saying?
Nah, if you nut, it like a couple of pumps. Like, I had them type of shit, like...
No, but if the girl comes and then you come after her, it's never nutting early.
Oh, it's cool. But how you gonna get that
you
to happen?
You wanna have sex for longer, for sure, but it's never considered nutting early.
If
you
both
define
together.
What is coming too fast. Like, if we fuck for 30 minutes and you don't come, and I come, I still nut it early.
That's different. Not 30 minutes. I'm talking about, like, within...
You ain't satisfied.
Like, I've had sex, and it lasted for probably 2 minutes. And
don't you feel good about yourself?
No, granted, that feels nice, but at the same time, if it happens all the time, it's like, the fuck.
But isn't it worse if you fucking for an hour all the time and he won't nut?
An hour's...
He just can't nut. What would you rather, a guy who nuts 2 minutes and you got the best pussy in the whole world, or a guy is an hour, he's just fucking you? And
but
it's
look,
like a,
if he, look, all I'm gonna say, if you nut early, you better eat her out then or something.
Not after you nut.
Yes.
After? That seems wild.
No, I can't even do anything
is
after.
Is that backwards?
Yeah.
That's like having a peanut butter and jelly outside
what?
A sandwich. Right? It's just a... It'd be messy as hell, right?
Oh my God.
I got time for that shit.
Yo, that was was the best for wax. Good job.
I don't know. It seemed like not right. I wouldn't want that.
You don't eat her out after nothing?
She's like, not, if you didn't, oh, no. After is wild.
If you feel like you didn't do your part, you wouldn't know? She's got to deal with it?
No.
Eat out my wife?
Yeah.
Yo, y'all are crazy, bro. Come on, yo.
We ain't paying attention in life.
Come on.
Interesting.
Listen, sorry. I love mine.
You wouldn't know. You're gonna be married one day. You're gonna be like, "What the fuck are we doing this for?"
Yeah,
what, this is sex? Ridiculous.
No, all the foreplay, that kind of shit. That's
I,
when
my
young.
Love language is touch. Like, I need that.
All right. Once you love, you don't need that no more.
Exactly.
Once you get married, you love.
That ring does something to your finger. It goes into your arm and to your heart. That's why they make
you,
the
you're
ring
gonna be sitting
side.
There like, man, I really want my pussy licked. Then you're gonna see your ring like, do I?
Mm-hmm.
I'm pretty sure.
You think?
The only thing, I'm going to look at my ring and be like, yeah, I want to see my head, my hand on his head while he's eating me out.
This girl's a fucking animal, yo. Just a sad.
She need prayer.
Stop objectifying us men, yo. We're just out here trying to satisfy you, okay? All right, guys, we're going to take a break for a second because I know what you got. You got a music subscription, right? Of course you do. At-home fitness subscription? Yes, definitely. Food delivery subscription? You don't have, but you should because it's a thing. Time to try Dash Pass by DoorDash and unlock those savings you didn't even know were missing. Dash Pass is a membership that offers unlimited $0 delivery fees from thousands of restaurants, grocery stores, and convenience stores. With your membership, you can save an average of $4 to $5 on each order you place for delivery or pickup. That means, on average, Dash Pass pays for itself when you order twice a month. Think about that. That means essentially you're getting free food if you're ordering twice a month. With over 18,000 restaurants eligible for Dash Pass, you may even find a new favorite restaurant. Flowers, pet supplies, groceries, DoorDash has so much more than just restaurants. Whatever you're using DoorDash for, additional savings await with unlimited $0 delivery fees with Dash Pass. Try a free month of Dash Pass now. Okay, and watch your savings add up. Start or stop using your membership anytime after your free trials. You basically can just try it and see if the savings is worth it, see if it saves you the money. And if it does, you just keep running it because why would you not want to save more money? If you're ready to save money on your DoorDash orders, DoorDash is offering a free month of Dash Pass right now. Stop spending money on delivery fees. Try Dash Pass from DoorDash today for free. When you've got zero delivery fees, you're free to get more because you can. So start your free month today. Also, this episode has been brought to you by Squarespace, okay? Domains, websites, online stores, marketing tools. Squarespace is the all-in-one platform to build a beautiful online presence and run your business. You'll find what you need. Whether you're showcasing your work, blogging and publishing content, selling products and services, announcing upcoming events, or anything you can dream of, buying a domain from Squarespace is easy because there are no hidden fees or price hikes. And get to know your audience with their analytics tools, okay? Those include insight on the page views, traffic sources, time on site, audience geography, and more. It's all so simple too. Start with a design template and use drag and drop tools to make your own, okay? All websites are optimized for mobile. Your site looks great on any device. Every Squarespace website and online store comes with a suite of integrated features and useful guides to help maximize prominence among search results. These SEO tools are paramount. So head to squarespace.com/idiot for a free trial. And when you're ready to launch, use the offer code idiot to save 10% off your first purchase of a website or domain. That's squarespace.com/idiot with the offer code idiot for 10% off your first purchase. Now let's get back to the show.
All right. Anyways, do you guys want to go to Ask Idiot or y'all want to have...
Let's do one more topic discussion so I can get off y'all laughing at me for having a fucking condom fall off.
Well,
in a pussy.
Since we're...
He thought everybody was going to be like, me too.
Yeah. I did think that.
It popped and went this way.
Yes.
Okay. Well, what'd you guys think about Diddy dating Bow Wow's baby mom?
You said who?
Diddy dating Bow Wow's baby mom.
Bow Wow got an impressive roster, yo.
Yeah, he does.
Yeah,
like,
come on.
That guy got to be charming.
He's been broke for decades.
I don't know how much money he got.
Why do you think he's broke?
That's the way you always read these articles about these rappers that are broke and then Bow Wow flexing like he got the private jet and he's in fucking Coach.
He does like to lie about that.
There's a whole Bow Wow challenge.
I know, but...
That's probably why he got his money, because he's in Coach.
Ooh.
I'm the ones who save all their money.
That's interesting. And he has been on TV or film for years.
I'm hosting 106 in Park. Let me tell you something. If you're a little Bow Wow and you find yourself hosting 106 in Park, something went wrong.
He used to call himself Mr. 106 in Park. Yeah. Because he used to have the top videos.
Yeah. And then you go host that
motherfucker.
Video
to host is not the
right. Can you imagine if fucking NSYNC started hosting Total Request? You'd be like, well, something fucked up happened.
Well, one of them is hosting like Love Island.
There you go.
Yeah, exactly. That's not that
good. He ain't doing great.
Yeah.
I mean.
What was the topic?
Diddy's fucking his baby mom.
Diddy and Bow Wow are friends. He like just came from, well, not just came from, but you know, Bow Wow used to party with Diddy and everything.
Yo, when you get successful, I don't know, maybe Bow Wow feels this way.
He said he had to talk around with him.
But I don't know. I think you reach a certain level of success. Like a lot of these guys reach a certain level of success and then like, they don't have as fragile egos as the average person
does. You know you got to pass along. They all pass along. You got a group of girls, they know they're going to be passed along.
That's what I was saying last week.
The knee-jerk reaction that Taylor feels right now, I think the average person feels, right? Because their ego is tied into their partner so much. Like, the partner is a reflection of them, and there's, like, this ownership and almost, like, property type feeling.
It's more so they're friends, though. Like,
We don't know that.
They are.
But even this, the girl, they know these girls going to be passed along. He probably got her for a couple of months, and then he get passed along to the next one. That's just how it is. It's okay. There's no way a lot of these other girls, I cannot get mad at none of the guys that I know dealt with any of the other girls that I dealt with.
So like how did he mess with his son's ex-girlfriend?
He knew as a pass along. He knew why he had that girl there. That girl knew why she was there. She's like, I'm having her for a couple of weeks.
Also, if you're Diddy's son, he gave you everything. He can't take one thing.
Come on.
He provided for you a lot.
That's only 10 toes and 10 fingers.
You don't think that's like kind of, that's like your dad.
Also, that's a compliment. Like Diddy's taking your old work.
If you were Diddy's son and he took the girl that like you were dating, say you actually have feelings for her.
Baby my mama? Dad smashed any one of my girls. No, I'm not talking about baby mom. Shut up.
I'm talking about Lori. What?
Yeah. He said, if my dad smashed any of my girls, that'd be dope. And then I think you said, shut up, Wax. Him saying to you.
If my dad probably came before, shut the fuck up. Your mama hear you.
You wouldn't care if your dad smashed?
Yes, I will. He's married to my mom.
But outside of that, you wouldn't care.
If my dad wasn't married to my mom, and when I try to get my dad some pussy, probably isn't that what everybody like? It's like one bottle of wine.
If you guys
share liquids and shit like that, that's basically intel.
Who's sharing liquids? Y'all are haters, man.
So hold on. So you nut, it shoots off?
No. That's disrespectful. That's disrespectful. Now you're disrespectful.
I'm just trying to be true. Like, that's... You be like, yo, watch this trick. And you nut the fucking
This is what it is. You nut.
Okay.
Okay. You nut in the condom. The condom fills with cum.
Okay.
Okay, so now there's liquid on the inside of the condom. So now the inside of the condom can move around very easily.
All right.
Okay? Now you start to get soft. This girl is still riding, grinding, squeezing, right?
So it gets smaller this way?
My dick gets smaller because it's soft. My dick is bigger when it's hard than when it's soft.
But I didn't know it gets smaller this way.
It gets smaller in every way when it's soft. When it gets soft, it's smaller in every way.
I guess so. Your dick is the same size?
No, I've never used a condom, but that makes perfect sense. You having the same girth dick, erect and soft, that seems weird.
That's kind of crazy.
Your dick doesn't get small.
No, it's baby. I didn't say anything.
Take your dick out right now. Your dick
just raises up like the cat hand in the fucking Chinese food spot. It's the exact same size.
I'm just saying for you making it seem like it was like this.
Wax, you were really bodying him earlier, and now you're the one looking weird.
You ready? Here it is. Mario eats a mushroom. Mario hits one of the Koopa Troopas, whatever like that. Little Mario again. That's it.
But you making it seem like it's like, hold on. You making it seem like it goes from like this to like this.
What?
Like it gets, that's.
You have to use the same thing.
Yeah, exactly. Like, what do you?
Okay, so you make it seem like this to make it like this.
Baseball bat to wiffle ball bat.
Wax.
Yeah.
All right, I guess.
Baseball bat to wiffle ball bat.
And now you have liquid on the inside of the condom. So the condom is moving around.
Exactly.
Before, like you know how you like don't know how to put on a condom where you don't squeeze the top of it? You know what I'm saying? And then the shit can just like go down and like morph. Your head goes into the fucking thing. You know what I'm talking about? You got to squeeze the top or else you just rip through the fucking condom. Yes. So I feel like I'm talking to someone who's never used a condom. I know you haven't.
That's how you do it.
You never use a condom. Wait, you never use a condom before?
My wife and I were each other's first, so why would we be gay and
shut up.
Condom?
No, what? For real. God. Yeah, for real.
Yeah.
Like, he's the man.
Yeah, he did
that's
it right.
So sweet.
He is really the man.
That's why I judge you so much.
So I say to you, because I know this guy does not know how to use condoms.
Right.
No, I do. Okay?
What are you talking about?
Yeah, my shit stays on, at least.
Does it? How many kids do you have? How many kids do I have?
I just wasn't using them at that time. But I know how to fucking put them shits on. I put this shit on. It's a little different, but I hear what you're saying.
How do you put it on?
You just put it on the right way. You just gotta, just like you said, hold right there.
What the fuck
are you doing?
What the fuck?
Yo, it looked like you were peeling a banana.
Alex, what you don't got a condom on you? Damn, God, I want to see.
we need to see you put on a condom.
Yes.
Not on your penis, on something, on Akash's penis.
I'm a whole fiance out here. My girl gonna kill me. But just like, you know.
I don't know what that move is. I don't know what that is.
What are you doing?
It's not a banana. Oh, wait, he's trying to say it. What are you trying to say?
What are you talking about? I'm a fiance. Because
you're doing this.
I just don't know what that is. Al?
I don't know what's going on. What you mean?
No. I don't know what that is. I don't know what
maybe yeah, I don't know I could be wrong.
Are you talking about banana? Because that's what it looks like you're peeling.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's what I say. This is the same guy who catches his shit in his hand before he uses the bathroom. Maybe all his tactics are off.
That's what I'm saying. It's no
I was feeling really bad about myself earlier, and now I'm fucking redeemed.
Redemption.
This is the person who showed me how to put a condom on is probably not the same person who showed you how to put a condom on.
Yeah, that is a fact.
That's all it is.
Now,
okay.
Did they show you how to put the condom on with a condom? Because I don't know what it goes like this in a condom.
Did you just watch a chimpanzee eating a banana? I think it's the same.
Put it on. That's how you just fucking put the shit on. You got to hold it and put it on.
No,
but you're
I don't,
doing this like.
Yeah,
what?
That doesn't make any sense. You hold the top.
I ain't put it on a long time.
You hold the top and then you roll it down.
Yeah.
How the fuck you roll it?
Wait, what?
Oh my God.
Yo.
Son, you're not using condoms, son.
I use condoms a long time. Baby,
this guy really not using
on.
Condoms, bro.
Yo.
No, this is crazy.
Yeah, I said they have one because.
You're not using condoms, bro. I honestly believe right now you've been sticking bananas into your dick. Right. I think you've been using them like a fucking plug for the bathtub and you just stick it in.
Maybe I'm wrong.
I'm trying to figure out why
are
you doing twice?
Listen, how do y'all wipe yourself? I bet you it's probably different than mine.
Yes.
Well,
different.
Absolutely.
Yes.
It's different.
You know some people
open up the condom packet. Like take out the condom. Right? Open up the condom packet. Take out the condom.
Take the condom
right?
out. The circle thing.
Pinch
Life
the
saver.
Top. Right?
Why
put
do you
it over your dick. Roll it down your dick.
Okay.
That's it, right?
Yeah, you can go to health.
Do a shaft.
You pinch the top.
Do we got a shaft?
So the sperm has a place to go. And if you don't do that, then it can break much easier.
That's how
you
get pregnant. Okay.
Yeah.
I know.
Yeah.
Yeah. You don't want it too
okay.
tight.
And you don't have to know that because it's not for you to know.
Yeah.
But you should
But
know.
Don't you guys learn this? But you guys didn't learn this in health class?
We did.
My health class didn't teach this.
You know what? They were probably putting condoms on bananas in health class. And I think after that, he's just like, I think you could just use the banana. I think the banana is doing most of the heavy lifting.
I think
here.
Wax saw that first step when they peeled the banana and he just was like, I got to peel the condom.
I probably fucked up.
This is one of the greatest comebacks I've ever seen. Schulz was down big.
I was down so big.
Big in the first half.
I was down so far. I honestly, if you're lying to get me out of this, I really appreciate it. I think you're one of the best friends that I've ever had.
I'm telling you. Let me show you something.
This is 3-1 LeBron and the Warriors kind of
you
stuff
got
right
one?
Here.
There we go. All
okay.
right. Let's
oh
see
my
what
God.
All right, go.
All right, go ahead.
All right. Let's see you.
That was actually a pretty impressive catch, one hand.
Yeah. Do we have anything he can put it on? No, like, before you do it.
Put
yeah,
on
yeah.
this can. Put on, yeah.
Yeah,
put
you
on
can
the
put
can.
It on that.
Yeah,
now,
put on that.
Before you do it, I just want to let you know. Show the guys. Show the guys how you put on a condom. Just so,
yeah, so do the pantomime. Don't open it.
Mime it. Mime it. Mime it.
I'm a fiance. I don't even know if this is okay. Just yeah, ask her.
Okay. Go.
All right. So you.
Has she been okay with you putting it, on a condom like that?
Boom, boom. Then you pull it down.
What is what is this and this?
Shifty is at, yeah, again.
You roll it out? Like unrolling? Yeah, pull it. Shit, watch this.
Mark, have you used condoms with your girl before you, once? Did you?
I didn't take out both ends of it.
That's what it makes you seem like it's adjustable.
You're right. You okay. Go like this, right?
Okay. Okay.
Oh, no, you got to go like this side.
Okay.
Right?
Yeah.
Well, you put it like this, right?
Yeah.
Again, like I said, you got to do this all the way over.
Oh, shit. No.
You got to do it over.
Cap. Because doing this on one side would never allow the other side to just stay there. It's easier to roll it on both sides.
How the fuck would you roll it?
What do you mean? You're
hold it like this and
now.
Just go like that and roll it down.
There's no way you rolling this like this. You got to put it over the motherfucker.
Nah, it's cat, bro. You're lying, bro.
You never know.
It don't work. Look at him trying to do it. And your dickhead's not bigger than that little silver thing?
But you got
to
squeeze. This shit not squeezing. You can't squeeze this
go
shit.
Go like this and just roll it. Watch. Go like this and just roll. Stop it. So, yeah. If the glove don't fit, it wants to quit.
Let me show
this
you.
Is hilarious.
Let me show you how to do it.
Watch this.
Ready?
Go ahead.
Ready?
1, 2, 3, go.
Ready?
Look, come on. Oh, nah, good job.
Hold on. There we go.
You bullshit with life. Look at you. You can't even do it.
There it is.
Nah. You cheated.
Ready?
You cheated.
There it is.
Nah,
there it
is.
Wait, first of all, what size condom is this?
What?
What size condom is that? Yeah. Okay, all right. Let's say,
what do you mean, what size mean condom? Look at that shit.
What's wrong with that?
You're not fucking nobody.
He didn't roll it all the way down.
Talking okay. about Taylor. That's why you lost the race. Damn near took off. So that's what it is, okay?
All right,
and
so
if you got a tight pussy Brazilian, then that shit just comes off.
Exactly.
Add it!
Got it right
there. Add it!
You got me on the ropes.
It's off. It's off. See? It's off. I must have unscrewed my dickhead. There it is.
One sentence too many, dog.
I know.
One sentence too many.
You had it.
Yo.
I was out.
You had it.
Wax, how you were doing it, though, how long does it take you to put a condom on? It took you mad long.
You really don't. It's like you got to hold it, but
doesn't
you
doesn't it explain
it.
A lot now?
Yes.
You can't squeeze that. You can't squeeze that right there. You can squeeze it and just and put it on. What are you talking about? Listen, I'm a fiance.
What else we got?
No use.
All right. Do you guys want to do church announcements and then?
Oh, shit. Church announcements. Yo. Wax, hit them.
Yes, I got the whoswax.net. Go to there and go get your mask from the Who's Wax paintball. You go ahead and sign up over there. I got the gun range over there that'll be out there really soon. We got Bully and the Beast on Wednesdays. I want y'all to go ahead and start listening
to that. This week's mad funny.
Me and L'Oreal out there talking shit. I'm always in trouble. And, Whatever She Says is back. And those gummies, whoswax.net, man. We got the gummies and we got the lemonade. Yeah, go ahead and go grab that stuff, man. This marijuana game is actually doing good. I'm in 36 stores in LA.
Hell yeah.
Let's go.
I got a new drop next week that's coming. So, you know.
I actually have someone happen. For you too that wants to put your gummies in there.
Yeah, dope. Man. Anybody got gummies in your area, in your store, y'all legal to CBD? Holler at me. Jump in the DMs. Let's do some business. I'll put some money in your pocket.
Akash, what do you got?
Yo, this Friday I am at the Secret Group in Houston. I think might have found some more tickets for the first show. We're going to be able to sell some more. Second show, still got tickets available. This Tuesday, I'm going to be at New York Comedy Club in Gramercy. I'm doing a night. I got both shows, so come through. And then October 21st through 23rd, I am at the Stress Factory in New Brunswick. And November 6th, I'm at the Red Clay Comedy Festival in Atlanta. Tickets at akashsingh.com, AKAASH.
I'm going to be canceling actually all my shows as I recover from penis enlargement surgery.
I'm in trouble. My hands are in trouble.
Infamous tour. Say what?
I'm gonna get in trouble. She smelled my hands.
I know. Right. The infamous store. Guys, we are gonna be in Las Vegas this weekend. The show's sold out. Thank you so much. Then we're gonna be in Louisville and we're gonna be in Cincinnati. Still a few tickets left for those shows. Make sure you go get them. TheAndrewSchulz.com. We added a bunch more shows to the tour. So make sure you check it out. Second show in San Francisco, second show in Chicago. We also got a second show in DC, coming to Indianapolis, Minnesota. We'll be in Jacksonville and Boston for New Year's. Go check out all those shows. Get those tickets before they're sold out. Okay. I'm telling you this right now so that you don't hit me the week of like, yo, how do I do it? I told you right now. TheAndrewSchulz.com. Go get that. Thank you so much. Taylor, take it away.
For Ask an Idiot. All right. So here's one for you. Okay, I like, yep. You know, how to, you know, get Wax. So who do you think will win in a fight? Wax or John Cena?
Wax.
Cena.
Wax.
Oh, you're going for Wax this time.
100%. Yeah. I don't think John Cena would be able to beat Wax up in a fight. I mean, yeah, I don't know. I think I'd beat John Cena.
Really?
I think in a boxing match, does he have any like boxing training or anything like that?
No, fight. Just a fight, not a boxing match. Fight.
Oh, straight street fight. I mean, he's definitely way stronger than me. He's like a much bigger guy. So if he maybe grabbed me, probably has experience, you know, doing like real wrestling, not the actual wrestling. So if that's the case, probably throw me around or keep me on the ground. But like a boxing match, that kind of, if he doesn't have any experience, then.
Yeah, boxing match, fair. But a real fight, Wax and John Cena, be good.
I think Wax. I mean, yeah. I don't think John Cena has a background in fighting. He's an entertainer. He's like a theater actor.
Do you call wrestlers theater actors?
Yeah, it's theater.
Is it?
Was he a football player at a high level? I know some are, like The Rock played at BU.
I mean, it's skill with everything that you do, but the thing is, people don't understand. It's like, I really do this. You know what I'm saying? Like, I sell everything in the world. Like, next thing you know, next week I sell puppies. You know what I'm saying? It's just like, oh, Wax sell things. He know how to play the piano. He know how to do this. Like, what? No, I really, before I do all that stuff, I could, like, fight the best out of everything I do, so. Mm.
You know. Okay. Well, what about you? I meant to ask you for the drinks. You don't drink?
I don't drink. I'm gay.
Oh.
Yeah. Really, I'm no fun. I'm really no fun, actually, when you get down to it. I'm not a fun time.
You're a comedian. How are you not a fun time?
That's why I had to get funny, because I don't do shit else. There's only one way you're going to hang out with me if I'm funny. I'm not going to drink with you. I'm not going to chase pussy with you. I better have jokes.
Yeah, you're right.
Facts.
I've been trying to chase pussy with you.
I'm sorry. I don't really want to. That was really your first time?
Yeah. That's me and my so wife, beautiful. Dog. We were with each other's first time.
I've been
trying to
get pussy for years. Yeah.
Yeah. I will only fuck Wax.
Yo. Okay.
That's why you never got none.
All right. So the Pineapple 22 wants to know, is there anyone you still get starstruck around?
Jesus.
Yeah. I think Jesus, I'd be starstruck for sure.
Jesus is a humble ass dude. I wouldn't get starstruck around him. That's a regular guy. There's a lot of amazing things.
You also don't believe in him.
I believe in him. Yeah. I just think he's just, yeah. We believe in everybody. Hindus believe, that's what makes it so easy. You just believe in all of it.
All of it?
Yeah. It's all just different forms of the same God. And we say, like, however you get to the mountaintop, that's fine.
Yeah. Who would I be starstruck? Obviously, if I met fucking Jesus, I'd be starstruck. Yeah. I think I'm starstruck by people that I'm like super, I just respect their talent.
Okay.
You know, so like, it doesn't matter if they're famous. Like, if there's someone who's really famous, but I don't respect their talent, I could give a flying fuck.
Yeah, peace.
But if there are people who I really respect their talent and they're maybe not even that famous, I just think that they're brilliant, then I would be a little bit more nervous around
them. Yeah.
I think I'd be starstruck around super famous people I don't like, the Kardashians. I wouldn't be like, oh my God, but I'd be like, whoa, that's a fucking super famous person. This is crazy.
Also, like, it depends the environment you meet these people in, because like, a really famous person changes everybody else's energy.
Yes.
And you start acting weird too.
Yeah, and I'm also like fascinated by that ability.
Yeah.
Like I was at Carbone, I think Drake came in. We don't know, it was in the back, but they just started playing. They went from 50s Italian music to straight Drake for like 45 minutes. Yeah. CLB all the way through. Somebody was smoking weed back there. Like, wow, how are you smoking indoors? And then I'm like, oh shit. And then we tried to take a picture and they were like, no. Not of Drake, just in general at the restaurant. Yeah. They were like, no. So I was like, oh, I think that might. And then you start being like, whoa, this guy changed the whole restaurant. Yeah. Everything, like, imagine being so famous.
Yeah,
they just play your shit as soon as you walk in.
It just becomes hard to socialize with people when they're so caught up in the famous person in the room. So now you're having a conversation with somebody, but you know that they're really just paying attention to the famous person. You know, so it's not. I'm sure you've experienced this, like with guests at Breakfast Club, or even just being around Charla. Like, you're trying to talk to somebody and that person is so excited that Charlotte's there, or that that like famous, you know, person that is in the fucking room. And like, it's not even a real combo you're having.
Yeah.
So that also makes it very hard to be normal in those positions.
What do y'all think about with Shaq saying that he don't want to be a celebrity no more? He wants to be a
The way he worded it is so funny. It's just Shaq being Shaq. I thought that too. I was like, wait, Shaq doesn't want to be a celebrity. Then you read his statement.
No, not me, but you know, that's what guys just say. You know, yeah, when you are that. You know what I'm saying? Not me. I just say it like.
Okay. Say.
We get it, Wax.
You got a big dick. No,
you got a huge. Hey, wait, wait. Your dick's huge, bro.
No, I'm not.
I just want you to know. Hey, from me to you, dude, your dick is fucking huge.
I'm just saying. That's what Shaq can say. He know he like one of the fucking.
Yeah.
Honestly, to have a big dick world and be faithful is so gay. It's, you're so gay for having this monster dick and just
stupid
using it for one person.
Stupid.
That's like, you're wild. It's gay, selfish. Yo. You're wild.
That's like having a fucking a bus, a 24 passenger.
Yo,
and you just only have one person.
What's
in
Travis
there.
Scott's daughter? That's you.
What's that?
When Travis Scott had the whole, her daughter had the whole school bus for herself to go to school in.
It's fucked up.
That's you.
It's fucked up.
Fucked up, bro.
You ain't shit, man.
But you know the most famous person, like I'm Drake and nobody.
Drake is a regular person, Jay-Z, though.
But yeah, yeah. You know, but he got me most? It was Pops from the Wayans Brothers.
Yeah.
Really?
Oh, fucking dude. Come on.
More than everybody. Really? You know, we see everybody. Like, who the fuck haven't I seen?
John Witherspoon.
I've been people's houses
best
and shit. Like, all right, boats and parties. Like, I'm going to smoke weed. But as soon as I seen Pops, I'm like, man, Pops talking shit. Martin, I was really excited
everyone
to see
was
Martin.
People from
to
your childhood. Yeah. Like, the Wayans Brothers is a big
Wayans
show when we were kids. Yeah.
Childhood. Martin was from childhood.
Yeah.
My Jerry
love
Springer
goes bang, bang, bang.
Yeah.
You like Jerry Springer?
Yeah, like.
I couldn't be less.
And Maury. He was happy with Maury.
Yeah, me and Maury real cool. I told him he fucked my life up. Like, people that impacted my life.
Yeah.
Like, I really don't care about what everybody else is like. Oh, he's famous. I'm like, he gave me some money. What the fuck he do?
Yeah. I remember seeing Madonna at the Comedy Cellar, and I could care less, but I've never seen like gravity around a human being like that before. Like, it was unbelievable.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
People couldn't even talk. I was trying to talk to people in the back table, right? And like, don't get me wrong, it was exciting seeing someone who's that famous for a second, but like after that, like, let's get back to it. But there was so much fucking energy to this one human being. Yeah. The entire place stopped. And she knows that.
Yeah.
She knows if she gets up from her table, everybody's looking. Is she leaving? You know
what she's doing.
Yeah, and like,
would y'all want that though? Like, famous? I wouldn't want that either.
Charles Barkley said that about hanging out with Michael Jordan. He's like, I'm famous. I know famous people, but he slid those exact words. When people see Mike, they can't even talk.
Yeah.
He's like, I've never seen anything like it.
And that will warp you. Jordan, yeah. It takes like a real strong internal constitution to not be changed by that.
I don't know if anybody's that strong. I've heard Beyonce is really nice.
Yeah.
But I still imagine that's got to change you. Apparently, Tom Brady, I just read like a little, there's some book that's coming out about the Patriots, but during the first Super Bowl week, he was like trying to go out to get a drink and bourbon suit with his boys, and then he like couldn't because there were too many photographers and he had to like sneak off, and he called his parents after they won and he said, our life is about to change, you're about to change as people, I'm about to change as a person. We're never going to be the same after this. Like, he just knew that you're not going to be the same walking out of this. You can't.
Yeah, but what if, I know it's got a lot of people that's on you, but what if it's just one person that wants you? Like, when you get necking a girl, like, really want to have sex with you. Mm. Like, is that something to you? Or you feel like the more people, like, which one is more important to you? Like, if I have a famous with all these people, or does one person love you like that?
I think if you're famous with all these people, a lot of them want to fuck you.
Yeah, that's true. But it's probably better to have like one woman. That,
what's more fulfilling? Yeah.
Yeah. For sure. That's what I'm saying.
Yeah, 100%. 100%. 100%.
Yeah, fuck all of them. You know what I'm saying?
Okay, well, let's keep riding with it because someone wants to know what's the greatest person you ever have met? Like, who's the greatest person you ever met?
The greatest person I've ever met.
Wax and his big ass dick.
Yeah. Wax's dick. Not Wax, but just his huge dick. Just how big and massive his dick is. That is the greatest person I've ever met.
You gotta have bosses that have all these fucking companies and shit. You gotta have big balls.
What?
They have all these fucking companies.
Oh, I'm sorry. I'm sorry. Your dick's not just big, but you have huge balls, dude. You're like, dude. Wax, bro. Wax.
here we were disrespecting your balls by just saying that your dick was so big.
The only fucking lead these motherfuckers out. You see how many fucking companies I got.
Now, I'm just saying, you have the biggest genitalia that anybody's ever seen.
I've never seen it.
Christ.
Yeah. Putting on condoms like swim caps, just fucking.
I don't even look at it.
That was crazy.
Do you even look at it? Like, why would you look at your dick? It's a dick.
Shut up, Wax.
Like, for real, y'all look at y'all shit for what?
I look at my shit all the time, dude.
For what?
Why? Wait.
What do you do when you pee?
What do you mean you look at it all the time?
So you look at it to pee? For what?
I love looking at it when I pee. Yeah. I love looking at it. Love examining it.
So when you pee, you don't look straight or look up or look around?
Don't you guys usually look down? Guys, you look down.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure you glance at the very least.
So if y'all do that, y'all definitely, when y'all kiss, y'all open your eyes.
What the fuck are you talking about? It's not remotely the same thing.
It's just like this.
You don't want to make sure you're not pissing on the seat?
Your head should go straight up. As soon as it starts coming out, it just automatically, your head go up. There's no way you pissing and seeing this shit go out. No.
Sometimes I do. Why not?
Think about it.
Yeah.
Are you that afraid of being gay that you won't even look at your own dick, Doug?
Whoa.
So it starts coming out, you just look straight. You don't fucking look down and just fucking meet, bro.
What are you looking for? Why not? Why not?
I think he thinks it's gay.
Do you think it's gay to look at your own body?
Just look at a dick.
Are you serious, Ryan?
I'm telling you.
It's yours.
Right, so if you nut in your hand, you're
so
fucking...
So you never jerked off in your life? Because if you have, you've given yourself a hand job.
I hate that shit.
Can I ask you a question?
What?
Have you ever had a girl riding you and then you're about to nut and then you come on yourself?
No, I never come to myself.
You what? Never came on yourself? Shut up.
You're a liar.
I never came to myself.
You're a liar.
I've come on myself more than I've come on women. That's 100% guarantee.
Where you come on yourself at? What the fuck?
I just come on my fucking tits, bro, on my stomach, dude. 100%, dude. Like, that's why I don't get why girls is a big deal to y'all. It's like, I'm coming on me too. It's equal.
Wait, what's the big deal?
Just to get your titties coming on. You know what I mean? Like, some girls are like, don't come on my tits. Be like,
I literally
whatever.
Never just went crazy and just nutted all over myself.
No, crazy. You just throwing it up like that. What are you going to do? Is that or the sheets? I don't like doing laundry. I'd rather wash my belly.
Nah.
You've never come on your own self?
They're lying.
I come on myself.
That's cat.
Oh, you're bugging.
No.
I never nutted on myself.
So where do you nut?
You never, when you pull
all
that.
Over
no, no, no.
Anywhere in the toilet. I just jerk off on the toilet.
Not jerking no. off.
I'm going to jerk off to myself. You get hard off of me yourself?
Don't put this on me. Yeah, I said I was
we never jerk off in
the mirror. I never said I was sexy, you get hard off yourself.
Is that how you came up with the name for your weed? Like, he's just looking in the mirror, eyes fucking like, what? Who's what?
Who the fuck is that motherfucker?
This guy looks just like me. He's beating off too. What a coincidence. This is crazy, yo.
All right. I have one more. Damn, I just lost it. But I forgot the person that said it, but they said, would you date a female you?
Would I date a female
dear God,
me?
No.
Yeah.
No. Dear God.
You think you're too much to deal with?
I will.
Oh, shit. I gotta go.
Okay.
Guys, this has been Brilliant Idiots, okay?
Yep.
What does Charlie usually say? I can't believe I haven't memorized this after 7 years. If we said some, you know, smart shit, you think we're brilliant. We said some dumb shit. We're idiots. This is the Brilliant Idiots podcast. Thank y'all for listening. Peace.